हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, होप एवरीवन इज डूइंग वेल एट होम। आयांच ऑनलाइन क्लासेस हैज टुडे ब्रॉट यू एन वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड इंटरैक्टिव सेशन व्हिच इज बेस्ड ऑन योर थर्ड चैप्टर ऑफ ज्योग्राफी, दैट इज वाटर रिसोर्सेज। चिल्ड्रन, एज यू ऑल नो, द थियोरेटिकल कंटेंट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर हैज बीन एक्सक्लूडेड। देन व्हाट इज द कंटेंट रिगार्डिंग व्हिच वी नीड टू बी कंसर्न? So that is nothing but the map work. Children, for our final exam, the part for which you need to be concerned is the map work. Now, map work is what? It deals with locating various resources or various places, you can say, on the physical map or political map which has been provided. Now, for this particular chapter, water resources, we will be dealing with location and labeling of the various dams which are constructed on the various rivers. So let's start with the session, children. Before we actually start with locating and labeling of the rivers and dams, let's take an introduction of the various major rivers which are flowing in India. Children, as you all know, like, India is blessed with many rivers. There are certain major rivers which get divided, bifurcated into their tributaries, and they have made a wide network throughout the nation which flows and quenches the thirst of the Indians. As well, they are helping the agriculture to get India developed. Now, this some of the examples which we have taken, like Ganga, Yamuna, Brahmaputra, Kaveri, Narmada, Tapi, and so on. As I said, we are blessed with various rivers which have found a wide network throughout the nation. Now, on these major rivers, we have constructed mini dams. Now, these dams, what are the purpose of building dams? Like, they provide a storage for the excess of water which is accumulated during the rainy season, which we can use as a reservoir when the period when we don't have a rainfall, like summer season. Like, various power generation projects are built up on the dams, which are filling up the need of electricity or power generation of the nation. So these dams are multi-purpose, and let's see on which particular river we have a dam located. So, after taking an introduction of the various rivers in India, let's move ahead. Now, in the latter part, we are going to see the major dams across the rivers which are spread throughout the country. Children, this is the textbook image which is provided into the third chapter, which is showing you the major rivers and the dams which are constructed on that river. Now, if I talk about, as per the survey in 2020, there are about 4,300 dams constructed in India. So the project, that is the dams project, it may be small or big, but we have near about 4,300 dams which are constructed on various rivers. Like, again I repeat, why these dams are constructed? They are acting as a reservoir for extra water which has been accumulated during the rainy season, you can say, which is again protecting us from the condition of flood. It is helping us in the power generation. Like, so that is the purpose. As like I said, like, as per the survey of 2020, there are near about 4,300 dams across various rivers which are built in India. Now, let's see, as like we saw certain major rivers, let's see certain major dams which are present in India. Like, the first ever dam, or you can say, if we move from north to south, the first ever dam which we come across is a Salar Dam, which is built across the Chenab River, which is present in Jammu and Kashmir. Like, as if I start from the north, the first ever dam which we come across is Salar Dam. Then The second one is the Bhakra Nangal Dam, which is located in Himachal Pradesh on the river Satluj. Then the third one is the Tehri Dam. Here we have it as Tehri Dam, which is present in Uttarakhand on the river Bhagirathi. The next fourth major dam is the Rana Pratap Sagar Dam, which is located in Rajasthan on the river Chambal. Then we have the Sardar Sarovar Dam, which is present in Gujarat on the river Narmada. Then we have the Hirakud Dam, which is present in Odisha on the river Mahanadi. Then we have Nagarjun Sagar Dam, which is present in Andhra Pradesh on the river Krishna. Then the last one is the Tungabhadra Dam, which is present in Karnataka, again on the river Tungabhadra itself. So these are certain major dams which are playing a major role in forming the network throughout the nation. Like children, as I said, as we don't have any theoretical part included in the chapter, so by the point of view of your exam, just the labeling and locating part is there. So if you just fix up the position of this 8 dams into the you can say map, then the whatever the blueprint marks are there for this particular chapter, you can score them out. So just pay attention when the location of the map has been done. So let's move towards now locating the dams. Now the first ever dam, as like I said, as we move from north to south, the first ever dam which we come across is the Salal Dam, which is present in Jammu and Kashmir. Now children, again here comes the question. The one which I have taken is the physical map. Okay, physical map is the one in which just you have the outline. Okay, here the entire map will not be divided into the states, you can say. The map is divided into the states, that is called as a political map. Now why we didn't take a political map? As here we are concerned with the location of the dams, here we will be needed or here we need to be concerned with the physical map, where just the outline will be provided. But we don't know exactly with which map you will be provided during the exam, so you should practice on both. So let's go for marking the Salal Dam. As you all know, the northernmost state of India is Jammu and Kashmir. So here, like close to this, you can say the deep thing, you can locate the Salal Dam. Okay, so this is what in Jammu and Kashmir, the first dam which we have located, that is Salal Dam. Then Salal Dam is located on the river Chenab. Now let's move towards the next dam. So out of 8, we have done the first one. Then next map which comes is, children, the Bhakra Nangal Dam. Now the Bhakra Nangal Dam is present in Himachal Pradesh. Now children, let's move a bit down and come to the state of Himachal Pradesh. Now here, as the outlines or the boundaries of the state is not present, like you need to be a bit accurate while locating the dam. Then next is, children, like a gap, a little difference in the location is acceptable, but there should be no major like a considerable change in the location will not be accepted. You need to be a bit precise. Now after locating, here was our Jammu and Kashmir. Then a bit down to it will be the Bhakra Nangal Dam. Here somewhere it will be like in Himachal Pradesh, we will be having the Bhakra Nangal Dam. Now here we have located the second dam also. Now let's move towards the third dam. Now the third dam was the Tehri Dam, which is located in Uttarakhand. Now the first Salal Dam we did, then we came to Himachal Pradesh, and then next, the third one is the Tehri Dam, which is in Uttarakhand. Now, just below the Bhakra Nangal Dam, here in Uttarakhand, we have the Tehri Dam. Let's locate it, children. As I said, A bit difference in the location is acceptable, but there should be no considerable difference in the locations. So be precise just whenever you are locating, be aware or imagine the state boundaries and then you can go ahead. Then let's go to the fourth one, which is the Rana Pratap Sagar Dam, which is located in Rajasthan. Now when you are going towards Rajasthan, okay, so it will be somewhere here in Rajasthan, that is nothing but the Rana Pratap Sagar Dam, which is located on the river Chambal. Then children, let's come to the next dam. Here we have the Sardar Sarovar Dam, which is located in Gujarat. Now it is just below the Rana Pratap Dam. Here I can locate it, like it is on the boundary of Maharashtra, I can locate it at Sardar Sarovar Dam. Then Sardar Sarovar Dam is again located on the river Narmada. Now let's move towards the next dam, which is the Hirakud Dam, which is located in Odisha, that is on the river Mahanadi. Now let's move towards this Odisha part. Now here we have Hirakud Dam. Now children, again there is a difference. Here it is termed as Hirakud or Hirakund also, okay? So whatever has been provided into the question paper, we will mention it as it is. Now this is the Hirakud Dam, which is located in Odisha on the river Mahanadi. Then let's go to the next dam. Next we have the Nagarjun Sagar Dam, which is present in Andhra Pradesh. Which is again the neighbor of Maharashtra. Now let's go towards this Andhra Pradesh. Here on the boundary of Maharashtra, we have it as Nagarjun Sagar Dam, which is built on river Krishna. Then next we have the Tungabhadra Dam, which is located on Tungabhadra River in Karnataka. Again, Karnataka, the boundary which sharing its boundary with Maharashtra. Now, let's build it. Now, below the Nagarjun Sagar Dam, you have the Tungabhadra Dam. Yo. So, children, in this way, you're going to practice the location and labeling of the various dams on the various rivers. Now here, if we need to summarize the thing, is what, like, you need to know the name of the dam firstly. Then the second thing which has to be known to you people is the state where the particular dam is located, and then you should know the name of river on bank of whom the dam has been constructed. If you know these three things, you can easily locate and label the dams throughout the nation. As like I said, here we will not be provided with the political map where there have been the separation or segregation of the states. Here you will be provided with a outline map, you can say, or a physical map where just the outline of India will be provided, and you need to locate the various firstly, when you start locating, you need to first identify which particular state it is on the map. Like the northernmost state is Jammu Kashmir. Then when you come down is Himachal Pradesh. Then a bit down will be Uttarakhand. Then when you shift to your east, what will be the state? When you shift to the west, what will be the state? On that basis, children, you need to identify the state firstly. Then the river on which the particular dam has been located. Now that's why, as per the map locating is concerned, you need to be very precise with the name of the dam, then the state where it is present, and then the river on which it is present. I hope, children, after seeing the location and labeling of the 8 dams on the various rivers, you are clear like how to represent the various dams, like location and labeling of them. Thank you for hearing the lecture. Like, Team Ayansh looks forward to have you on board. Please like and follow us on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter. For more detailed information, you can visit our website, that is ayanjonlineclasses.com, for more detailed information. If you have loved the lecture, don't forget to share and subscribe our YouTube channel, that is Ayanj Online Classes. Thank you.